Hi, Rost. I'll just take this off. Don't want him listening in. Hi, Rost. A lot has happened. Elizabeth Sobeck, she... couldn't have been my mother. She was an old one. She lived... ages ago. Still, there is a connection. The hatch... it thought I was her. It's really strange. Somehow... Elizabeth stopped war machines from... destroying the world. She couldn't save the civilization of the old ones. That was destroyed, obviously. But life... it survived. She saved life from... being devoured. I need to know how Elizabeth stopped the machines. If I can find the weapon she built, and use it, the Eclipse won't stand a chance. I went to the Grave Horde. It lived up to its name. Millions of people fought and died to give Elizabeth the time she needed to finish Zero Dawn. The weapon she built, it wasn't there, but... I found out where she built it. A secret base west of here. Right under Sunfall. The capital of the Shadow Carja. So, getting inside, it's... well, it's gonna take some doing. I crashed the Eclipse Focus Network. It was a... close call. I nearly died. A bunch of times. I saw it, Rost. Face to face. Hades. An ancient Pharaoh Titan, or... maybe something worse. When I opened the module casing, it was like... I had a vision. A world being destroyed. Exterminated. I think that's what it wants, Rost. Extinction. Anyway, I heard it. Blinded it. Made it so it can't see through the Eclipse's eyes, can't talk to them over distances. So it's time. Time for me to go to Sunfall and learn about Zero Dawn. Wish me luck. Well, Sunfall beckons. Next time we talk, maybe I'll know all about Zero Dawn. Goodbye.
Doing for Bahamut.
By the glory of the sun revealed, behold, radiant Edoman, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of Radiant Edoman does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little Huntress. The Green Tent, down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting.
Kinda busy.
We both know you're no killer for hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me, while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel. Gotta see the Sun Ring from on high.
Well, the Kestrels.
Ah, they want us to see this, boy. It makes quite an impression.
Rumor has it been Bahavis' employee.
This is insane.
Hardly.
They're going to see.
The food is from Dowager Queen Nasadi, little ones. Her Highness knows times are hard and helps when she can. Eat. Bring some home for your families, if you have one. I've heard whispers about you. Rides machines, fancy spear, delightful freckles. Some even say you have a conscience. How extraordinary.
Who are you? You're obviously not one of the Shadow Carja.
My name is Vanasha. For now, all you need to know is that I'm a whisper of reason in this howling pit of insanity.
I know how that feels.
I'm sure you do. And so does Uthid. He's a good man, so naturally the Shadow Carja want to murder him. I've done some digging, and I think he's headed for the Green Climb. It won't take those mercenaries long to find him. He could use some help, if you're so inclined.
How do you know Uthid is innocent?
I'm excellent at making inquiries. Look, he feeds orphans from his own rations and personally punishes anyone who hurts the old or infirm. The idea that he would try to kill Edelman is ridiculous. He must have found something that can embarrass the priesthood. Otherwise, Bahavas wouldn't risk marking such a well-regarded man for death.
Stop being evasive and tell me who you really are.
Stop being evasive? You might as well tell me to stop being charming. It's impossible, but I like you, so I'll tell you a secret. I have friends in Meridian, and I like to do favors for them when I can. Uthid might be of use to them, if he survives.
What makes you think he's on the Green Climb?
He knows he'll be pursued, so he needs a hideout that's both familiar and defensible. He once single-handedly held off an entire bandit clan in those foothills. My guess is that he'll fall back on what worked before.
I'll do what I can for Uthid, but what about you?
What about me what?
What will you do while I risk my life?
Useful things, little Huntress. Look for 3 dead trees south of Sunfall. They mark the start of the Green Climb. Good luck.
Yeah.
You're Threeto Hordeev, right? Vanasha sent me. What happened?
I got hornswoggled, that's what. Vanasha batted her lashes, wiggled her hips, and promised us treasure. Clear a path for the royals, she said. Sneak past the garrison and skewer a few watches. Hardly a bother. Little did we know there was a damned monstrosity lurking underground. When will I learn not to gawk at skinny girls?
Something attacked you from underground.
Oh, you picked that up, did you? I wondered why the Shadow Kaja didn't pay attention to the pass. Well, they don't need to. A rock-eating demon guards it for them. It tunnels in the dirt, breaks through the earth, and blasts rocks from its stinking face. I barely escaped. My comrades weren't so lucky. I might shed a tear if they weren't all cutthroats and cheaters.
So Vanasha needed safe passage for Nasadi and Idomen, but it didn't work out?
She made it sound so sweet and easy. Find the best path to the lake, make sure it's safe. What could go wrong? Turns out, a lot. Like bloody murder in the grinding jaws of a heinous death beast.
Why do you think Vanasha swindled you?
My crew came to Sunfall because we heard the bounties were fat. She offered us the fattest one of all, enough to retire on. It's my own damned fault for taking the bait. Should have known I'd end up with a rupture in my useful parts.
Vanasha will be here soon with Nasadi and Idomen. I've got to destroy that thing in the pass before they arrive.
You're not too bright, are you? Well, we didn't last long against it, but I'll tell you what I know. It has armor everywhere, a little less at the rear. And when it goes underground, it will lose track of you if you're quiet. You might even be able to keep it from going under altogether if you hit its big crooked arms hard enough. That's all I can offer, friend. I promise to look solemn at your funeral before I hit the bar.
Getting cooler. Dark soon. No space.
By the radiant sun, I can't believe it. I thought that evil rock jewel would grind you up. After that miracle, all we can do is wait. Vanasha will be here soon, along with a boat that'll take the royals across the lake.
Ah, little Huntress. Glad you accepted my invitation to play bodyguard. Where are your manhood, Eve? It looks like something chewed you up and spat you out.
That's pretty much exactly what happened.
The way is clear. Can we go?
I like how you always cut to the chase. In this case, literally. It won't be long before you're followed. Don't be afraid, your radiance. We've got excellent protection. Oh dear, here come the Shadow Carter, and they're very angry with me.
I'll hold them off.
Very noble of you, but when I start a fuss, I like to finish it. Not that your assistant isn't welcome. Hwadiv, get Itaman and his mother to the shore. Carefully. So it comes to this. I must say, after 2 years under the heel of these zealots, I'm ready to extract a little blood. Jinx it, but we might be in the clear. A bit late, aren't we, gentlemen?
Sorry, ma'am. The boat's waiting.
Damn, I spoke too soon.
This one's mine. Get to the boat.
You know, this time I think I might be out of my league. If anything happens to her, I will be very cross.
We're not going anywhere.
exactly a royal barge, is it? Oh well, defectors can't be choosers. Let's get aboard, shall we? You've done a good thing. Maybe even ended a war.
Maybe. But my war just keeps going.
Edomin, my brother. Welcome home. You have nothing to fear. You are now under the protection of the Sundom. My protection. As is your mother, she will not be harmed. You have my word, Law of the Sun. Aloy, it seems I see your influence everywhere. You've done so much for the Sundom, and it will always be appreciated. You have my thanks. May you walk in the light.
Appalling. I spent 2 years in the Forbidden West setting this up, and the redhead gets all the credit?
I'm still getting paid, right?
You'll be lucky if I let you live. I couldn't have done this without you. When we meet again, I'll give you a proper thanks, I promise.
I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure. As year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the Earth were laid bare. I suspect you'll have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identity scan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
But now I...
Guess you can't have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one whisking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now, will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
What was this place?
A holographic theater.
CD-01 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top-secret super-weapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague, if Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super-weapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating. Waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day, the day that life on Earth ceases to exist, is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
That doesn't make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
He said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it.
Blood coffee? Conflict cappuccinos?
Mr. Tate, I'm clearing you to proceed. Just go.
CD-02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth Sobeck.
You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim. The hope of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the reflourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake. Each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
Then, if it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh robot? And why does it want to kill me? And Apollo, the Archive of Knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
...that would benefit from antilopany morphologies. Though caprid forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobek, as I have conducted this comparative analysis of mammalian morphologies, I've gathered extensive data on the quaternary extinction event.
Oh? And your assessment? Gaia?
Logically speaking, the extinction was a natural consequence.
And yet...
I find the loss of megafaunal species unaccountably sad. That they passed forever into oblivion causes me to experience a grief that is difficult to describe. Am I malfunctioning?
No, Gaia, you're not. This is good. It's very good. You will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll bring the subordinate functions online and see where we stand.
Elizabeth, I detect distress. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
I realize that circumstances compel us to launch earlier than we hoped, but all subsystems are operational. The odds stand in our favor.
But what if... Gaia, there's nothing left out there. You can't even survive unless you're wearing an environmental suit. There are billions dead, in fear and agony. What if it was all for nothing?
Elizabeth, extinction was inevitable. Thanks to you, life will have a future.
You really believe that?
I believe in you, Elizabeth. In you, all things.
Pure logic won't cut it, Ted. To pull this-
We learn nothing from our mistakes?
Your mistakes, I think you mean?
All I'm saying is, give it a kill switch.
She was just born, Ted. I'm not gonna put a gun to her head while she's still in the cradle.
You talk like it's a child. What if it becomes a monster?
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
Of course, Gaia, go on.
I'm sorry to contradict you, but Mr. Pharaoh's argument is sound. At this point, the development of my psyche is not entirely predictable. To ensure preservation of life, a hardwired override is, I believe, a necessary safeguard.
There. Satisfied, Ted?
Jeez, Liz, just do what it says.
The Alpha Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
With this, I can restore the registry at the hatch inside Allmother. Open it. Go inside.
And grasp the secrets within.
Where I was born. Maybe. Maybe who gave birth to me.
Who? Are you really so naive? There will be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created?
Eclipse.
You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Suitable death in mind for you, child. My entire life, I've always known one thing with prophetic certainty. That I was destined for glory as a great champion of the sun. Even when Jaron was murdered, even when Meridian fell, I never doubted my destiny. Until you came along. When I heard that you had survived, a doubt took root in my mind. As sure as the sun rises and falls each day, those I am bade to kill die. And yet I failed. How? Why? With each dig site you attacked, each loyal soldier you killed, this pestering doubt grew. It grew when High Priest Bahavas went missing, and when the true Sun King Itamin was snatched away. It not only grew, but multiplied. I kept thinking of the moment my knife pierced your throat. One twist, a simple tug of the blade, and you would have bled out. In slaughter, I am a practiced hand. So why hesitate? Why fail my destined purpose?
I guess even a monster like you can have a glimmer of conscience. You didn't kill me right away. Turn your face to the sun, child. Dressing up murder as religious sacrifice so you could feel better about it?
No. I never doubted the righteousness of killing you. And yet, your words touch close to the truth. In my heart, I deemed the order to kill you unworthy of me. You were just a savage girl. So I thought at the time. Even still, I aimed to kill you, and yet did not. This failing troubled my thoughts, haunted every step. It was only when I captured you, down in that place, that I finally glimpsed the sun's design etched at length across the course of events. You were meant to survive that day on the mountain. Meant to interfere at dig sites and kill my men. Meant to eliminate High Priest Bahavas. Meant to snatch Itamin away. Conversely, I was meant to capture you. Here. So that you might die as a sacrificial offering to the sun. Everything as it was meant to be. Predestined and preordained.
Some destiny. You're following orders, not some grand cosmic design. You're a puppet, with Hades yanking the strings. A pawn pushed around by larger forces. It'd be laughable if there weren't so much killing involved. Hades is an ancient machine, not the buried shadow of Karja myth. It doesn't care about Meridian. It wants to kill everything and everyone. And you are its dutiful slave.
I serve not the buried shadow, but the sun in shadow. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, dark to light.
Do you really not hear how ridiculous that sounds? You've gone from serving an insane homicidal Sun King to an insane homicidal machine. You're moving down in the world, not up.
I'll remember those words as I watch your corpse burn. Whatever's left of it. You fail to grasp the point. As surely as you've been conquered, so has all doubt. And with certainty of belief comes unstoppable force.
Then enter this cage and put your faith to the test. See if things work out like you expect.
The circle has closed. Every element is in its proper place, exactly where it belongs. The errant beast, now caged, will serve her true purpose. A sacrificial animal. Oh, speaking of sacrifice, I forgot to tell you. After you crashed the Eclipse Network, I sent messengers into the east to rally the forces there and mount an invasion of the sacred land. I ordered every Nora killed. I was hoping to catch you there, but alas, it all seems to have been unnecessary.
Why butcher dozens of innocents for no gain? It's a waste of effort.
You're right. I won't even be there to enjoy it. In any case, I couldn't recall the order even if I wished to. Thanks to your destruction of the network, communication over distances is impossible. You not only doomed yourself, but an entire tribe. Do we not see the scorching judgment of the sun in these events? Your focus. Such a powerful device, isn't it? And yet, so fragile. So you see, this time, I did not hesitate. The knife has already been twisted.
Raja faithful, rejoice! Our years in shadow are over. A new dawn trembles on the horizon. A new day, soon to break. And when it does, the false Sun King will be dead, and Holy Meridian ours once more. In this, I have become an instrument of Prof to Sun, light to dark, night to day. Behold! Hold your seats! Can you not see the proof of the sun's blessing before your eyes? How else could shadows such as these prowl in broad light of day? Were they not approved by the sun and joined to our cause? Many years ago, to consecrate this great ring, the Radiant Chiron ordered many faithless crushed beneath the hooves of the behemoth. Mighty is the behemoth in the eye of the sun, but it is mightier still, infused with the power of shadow. Let this one, who schemed and slithered, be the first to die. Let her be the first of thousands!
The behemoth into the pillars.
Shadows. Kill her.
So you're here. Really here. You risked your life.
Of course I did. If you'd been killed, Venora's sacred mountain would never have given up its secrets.
Too bad you wasted your time, then. Helis destroyed my focus. And the Alpha Registry with it.
Not at all. The whole time I've been monitoring your focus, I've duplicated every data file you scanned. Installing that data to a new focus was trivially easy. Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
You're really good at making it impossible to like you, Silence. But I guess I need this.
It's time to see where you were born. Maybe you'll even learn why.
Yeah. Meet the machine that birthed me into this world. Isn't that how you put it?
I'll be off.
Wait.
Yes?
Since when can you override machines?
Ever since you discovered the technique. I had to destroy a corruptor to obtain the necessary parts, of course. But your example showed me how to do that as well. Yet another benefit of monitoring your activities through your focus. Truth be told, the underlying logic of the technique isn't so different from rites practiced by Banuk shamans. Though, of course, far more advanced.
Great. You're welcome, I guess. How did you track my location when I wasn't wearing a focus?
Really, Aloy. It doesn't take a genius to surmise that Helis would throw you into the sunring at high noon. I wore out 2 striders getting here in time, but I did. Now be on your way.
Helis recognized you back in the sunring. You told me that you'd assisted the Eclipse. Not that you knew the man who killed my... who almost killed me.
So now you know. The man is a serious threat. So let's do all we can to make sure that he and Hades don't succeed.
Right. I'll be on my way. To make matters worse, Helis ordered an Eclipse detachment to attack the Nora Sacred Land. The tribe's already weak. They won't stand a chance. You should come with me.
Well, absolutely not. I have preparations to make elsewhere.
What kind of... Why do I bother asking? You're not gonna tell me.
When the time is right, I'll be in touch. I'll contact you later. In the meantime, should you need to return to Shadow Carja territory, I brought armor to conceal your identity.
You think of everything, don't you?
One of us has to. Aloy. When you were recovering the Alpha Registry down in the Zero Dawn bunker, I was needlessly cruel. For your sake, I hope there is someone waiting there for you inside the mountain. Not a what, but a who. Yeah!